trombone and these displeasures. It is work from genetic labor. He studied trombone displeasures previously with autosomal dominant rate of inheritance, and we found new mutation, and we found pedigree with multiple occasions, multiple incidents. The pedigree analysis varies molecular genetics methods as direct or indirect gene analysis complemented. We investigated the correlation between type of mutation and phenotype, and we monitored 50 families with multiple cardiac genomes, exostoses, 10 families with cleidocranial dysplasia, 10 with hypochondroplasia, 60 with achondroplasia, 12 with pseudoachondroplasia, osteogenesis imperfecta, něco vyřešený osteogenes, 40 families, 10 with basal cell nevus syndrome, 20 with dentinogenesis and 10 with amelogenesis imperfecta. The most cases are obviously recognized as new, fresh isolated mutations. Multiple cartilaginous exostoses are represented in 25 from 50 cases as fresh mutations. Cleidocranial dysplasia, it is 7 from 10 cases with new mutations. Hypochondroplasia is represented in half cases as fresh mutations. Achondroplasia have 4 from 5 cases as fresh new mutations in the family. This is demonstration about dysplasia cleidocranialis, which is located at chromosome number 6. It is a gene for regulation osteogenesis, and mutations are autosomal dominant inheritance state. It is a regulating gene. This is a demonstration about achondroplasia. You can see here one child, estination from Estonia, and our patient, which is model for statue or patient with achondroplasia, where as model for statue. This is demonstration mother with achondroplasia, which have healthy twins after prenatal diagnosis of receptor gene for fibroblast, for receptor gene fibroblast growth factor 3. This is demonstration causative gene for achondroplasia, and this gene is causative for hypochondroplasia 2 and for thanatotrophic dysplasia. So, classical mutation location and minority cases are here and here. Achondroplasia was demonstrated in middle age. It is a statue from Florence, Italy, in 16th century. Next one. And in the same time, in Africa, were found this little statue, pseudoachondroplasia and achondroplasia. Pseudoachondroplasia have, according our finding, new mutation at 9 from 12 cases. Osteogenesis imperfecta, autosomal dominant type of inheritance, are represented in 19 from 40 cases as fresh new mutation. It is founder effect, effect rodonačelníka. Basal nervous syndrome patients are 8 from 10 cases as first mutations. Dentinogenesis imperfecta in 8 from 20 are as fresh mutations. And amelogenesis imperfecta, autosomal dominant type in the same percentage correlation as 4 from 10 cases. This is demonstration Mike talked about it. I would like to say that this condition is located to chromosome 19 near to gene for apolipoprotein B. It's very important for indirect genetic diagnostic. And this is another patient. Now it is age 8, and now is this woman 45. And this is typical clinical picture. And you can see here location. Sorry. This is Mendelian instance of man, caught, and location at short arm chromosome 19. This is gene for monomer cartilage oligomeric matrix protein, and molecular pathogenesis connected with post-translation processing of cartilage oligomeric matrix protein. Is when it's node mutation, this process is destroyed. And this is osteogenesis imperfecta, nesovršený osteogenes, our cohorts, and you can see here that most obvious is osteogenesis imperfecta type 1 without dentinogenesis imperfecta. The mutation affected in some cases only osteoblast, and in other cases are together with odontoblast, and both type of cells have Cramon precursor cells. This is osteogenesis imperfecta densitometric picture. It is very heavy case, and we have here overview mutation, excuse me, that is in Czech language. We have new possibilities for diagnostic. Mr. Marek demonstrated the first 8 cases, and we have now 35 cases, and it is not necessary all cases to present, but I would like to say some familiar case here. And for example, we found many mutations at glycin position. It is connected with fragments, glycine in collagen 1, bone collagen sequence. The most mutation is located to chain collagen 1 alpha 1, and minority is alpha 2. This is the next demonstration. For example, this is mutation stop type exon 50, and this is heterozygous mutations with production so-called truncated protein, and it is problem for macromolecule. In a normal case, have a healthy 3 chain, and the triple helix of collagen 1 is connected from 2 alpha 1 and only one chain is alpha 2. It is more complicated macromolecule as DNA, after my mind. Some mutations were located in proline. It is very frequent amino acid in collagen. Some cases were independent in both labor provided, and we have a friendly connection to labor in Belgium, MGM. And some cases are not diagnosed. We propose that is possibility for non-collagen type of osteogenesis. We have a very extreme case. It is the second case here. Ženština, která je měla výměnost. This woman has a child and born per section cesarea, and high at time pregnancy was 99 centimeter, and weight 99, and 28 kilogram. It is incredible. And next mutation here, please. I must only speeding, and causative mutations are very important for prenatal diagnostic. It's possibility in first trimester of pregnancy or classical amniocentesis at 16 weeks. And osteogenesis imperfecta is connected with dentinogenesis imperfecta, but not all cases of dentinogenesis imperfecta are derived from collagen. We marked the correlation between bone and heart dental tissues in selected cases of osteogenesis imperfecta with inborn effects of collagen 1. Osteogenesis imperfecta belongs to a group of osteochondral dysplasia with an abnormal bone density or incorrect formation of bone tissue. In the cases with osteogenesis imperfecta, the severity of changes in the heart dental tissue is an occurrence with the severity of the defects in the skeleton. This means that the defective function of odontoblast is in accordance with the degree of the defect of osteoblasts. And now about heritable primary defects of dentin. The normal picture of dentin is the tissue which forms a thick shell around the central pulp cavity and is capped with enamel. Dentin is tube tissue mineralized with calcium phosphate. I have here a picture, surface, dentin. And now about the heritable primary defects of dentin, we now classification after Shields. And we recognize type 1, which is connected this osteogenesis imperfecta, and primary defects of genetic type 2. This is demonstration. It is the dentinogenesis imperfecta with opalescent dentin, and this typical case of dentinogenesis imperfecta. We know the additional primary dental defects, but very, very problematic. Focal odontoblastic dysplasia and autosomal dominant defect of dentin development. We know mutation which caused dentinogenesis imperfecta. It is mainly mutation in dentin CLO phosphoprotein, which is referred as dentin CLO protein, glycoprotein, and phosphoprotein. Together, dentin CLO protein have been identified in people with type 2 or variety type 3 in North America. These proteins are involved in the formation of dentin, which is a bone-like substance that makes up the protective middle layer of each tooth. And this is location at chromosome, long arm, chromosome number 4. And this is an overview of many mutations which cause amelogenesis imperfecta, and it is another neurologic unit, heart tissue, and this is a connection to mutation dentin. Some locations are identical with dentin. It is interesting. For example, here, dentin cell protein in some cases is causative for dentinogenesis imperfecta, in other cases for amelogenesis imperfecta. This is familiar case report, father and one from his two children. And you can see here changes in decirrhosis mix and permanent dentitions. It is another correlation as dentinogenesis imperfecta. This is amelogenesis imperfecta. It is another boy, 16 years. This melanogram, paranormatic. Picture, orthopantomogram, and now about mutations at basal cell line syndrome or Korlin-Wolf syndrome. This is typical skeletal picture, typical faces is macrocrania, pericephaly, and most obvious complication is swelling from inflammation through keratocysts are very complication. Next one case, and this patient have typical station. Distancia viacromialis is shorter and distancia bicresta is wider. And I describe here the typical characteristics for syndrome, basal cell nevus syndrome. It is not osseous disease. It is precancerosis. Multiple basal cell melanomas are glios. And typical picture for dental keratocysts, previously Geoff keratocyst. This is surgery treatment, extirpation. There are present skeletal malformation of basal cell nevus syndrome. cranial complications, leaching of cell on a type. And keratinization of parents. And genetics of basal cell syndrome is very important. Leo Paes, his collaboration with Professor Reis from Germany, gene, it was published 1996 at Lancet, and many number of LOTC and possible candidate genes were excluded, and the gene finally is located at long arm chromosome number 9, and we note high degree of penetrance with variable expressivity. And our conclusion for our observation at 10 families with basal cell nervous syndrome. The first symptomatology is periosely in orofacial area. And the main symptom is the occurrence of multiple basal cell carcinomata and calcification, the fast CB2. And another symptomatology is here. And from genetic point of view, we know 23 affected, and very often it is unobvious at autosome dominant trait of inheritance, but it is a problem for little cohorts. We note four cases, fresh mutations, and all isolated cases are remaining. Six families are multiple through more generations. It is a relative heavy disease, and when is this situation, the most cases are fresh mutations. It is here in my conclusions. In the cases, the new mutation exists for all main nosologic units, direct connection to advanced paternal age, but not in all cases. From the founder effect, the mutation transmissions from 2, 3 or more generations were not relatively rare. The CV disease with influence to reproductive ability have higher incidence as fresh mutation in the populations. It is basic knowing from the population genetics. We have here two main signs: reproductive fitness and coefficient of selection. It is clear. It is without comment. And now about multiple cartilaginous exostoses, the most mutation is located at long arm chromosome number 8. It is a similar situation. Most cases are fresh mutations, but we note with help fish methods family with two generation transmission to demonstrate here, and we have possibility to demonstrate this ultraviolet and fish methods. It is similar as this interstitial relation shows gene. We have probes here for we have probes for and chromosome number 8 and chromosome X, and we note mesomeric dysplasia. This help fish methods, and signal at affected mother is double. This is slow signal, this is pale signal. It is it depends from interstitial tension, which is in heterozygous condition. And the son of the previous mother with this chondrosteosis, very wide, is here. This is pseudoautosomal region, and the same signal is not at chromosome Y. Palovy chromosome X, this is palovy chromosome Y, palovy chromosome X, and the Venice chromosome X are affected, the signal is slower. And bone dysplasias, we see the clinical picture, are also present as the fresh mutations. Moderate cases have the more probability to go through more iterations. In the mutation laboratory analysis and investigation for the related persons, is testing more simple and not so difficult as for the first problem in the family. It is very important for osteogenesis imperfecta, which have very large gene. It is very difficult to estimate the causative gene for first present for so-called proband. The knowledge of types mutation have significance for next prenatal diagnosis with use chorionic samples or classical amniocentesis respectively. That's all. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you for the presentation. Now, paper is open for discussion, some questions, notes, who are interested in this problematics.
Ale vás možná parupsky zprášívat.
Anyway, we
slovo panátno.
We cooperate with Dr. Kuklík 20 years and a lot of patients we diagnosed together and he gave genetic counseling to affected families and I think that this close cooperation was fruitful and I hope it will be in short future. And at present, very advanced progress is in molecular genetical methods and we are not, or we clinicians are not enough educated only. It is, sorry, it's the specialty of molecular genetics is in very high progress and at present this problematics is for young people educated in biochemistry and for clinicians, what is necessary to keep steps with them and know what indicate for some method. That is why I'm very glad that we cooperate with Dr. Kuklík, we indicate these special expensive investigations and finalize it will be the future for next generation when these results will be used for life of all affected children and families. At present it is more in the level of some research studies because investigations are really very expensive. Are there no other questions? I will go on in the program and